Hi there. Today I'm going to talk about this small amplifier. It's a very strange product. It's called Little Lanilei. It's 1/4 of a watt. It's handmade in the United States. And it's very strange. Now the small tube amplifiers are very fashionable. And this was one of the first ones that I found on the market like 10 years ago. It must have been more. 15 years ago, but I've had trouble trying to use this amplifier. It has a great sound, but if you just play the amplifier and turn the master volume up, this is how it sounds. Very quiet. You can turn the gain to the max, but the volume stays the same. There is a high gain boost. It's a bit more, you know, loud, but it's still like that. So I've tried to find a way to amplify this great sound. First I tried to use just an just a speaker, but the sound remains basically quite small. But then I realized you can use the line out if you use a sort of direct inbox, and I chose to use this Junction by Palmer, which is very famous. It has a cabin simulator and it produces a balanced output that is very helpful. And then I use the Bose S1 Pro, which I use almost everywhere as an amplifier. And the sound becomes much more interesting, as you can hear. There you have it. That's full gain. You can go much lower. That's midway gain. Quite soft. Now in the direct inbox with Palmer, you have options to sort of lower the level. So it gets softer and softer. But I keep it at 0, so you get the full blast. And this is the normal level. You can have a bright option, which is sort of a bit too bright for me, or a mellow one, which is quite nice actually. But with the normal level, you get basically the amplifier's sound. So, that's very basic. It just has some reverb in it, but it gets bigger. As you know, with Bose, you can go loud. And it still pure tube guitar sound. There are other tricks that you can do with this amplifier. You can turn down the master. It's softer, of course. The Bose end amplifier is good if you want to come up with a sort of a very balanced, quiet sound. I usually keep it very low, so all the hum disappears. So this is really nice indoors. These amplifiers are really interesting. They are some sort of a blend between Fender basic basement basically and a Marshall Plexi. I'm not very familiar with how they sort of wire these things. I'm not a very technical person, but really this sound is amazingly pure. Tube sound. And this amplifier is sort of very modern in many ways. It has this line out, which is very good for me with the stuff that I'm using. It has two outputs for speakers, and you can even use the effects. There's an effects output. Apparently, the producer of this little Lanley amplifier has had some problems with deliveries, but they're still offering this amplifier. You can get this amp with a much more powerful power amp, so you can use it by itself. But I really like this very sort of low output amplifier so that I can practice and record indoors in my flat. One last thing about this little Lanley amplifier. Some guitars work with this. This guitar is a Reverend Flatrock, which has low output humbucking pickups. It's excellent for this amplifier. Some other pickups, like normal humbuckers, not so good. But apparently all single coil pickups are good with the little Lanley. It's about $500, I think, still. So it's not extremely expensive, but quite nice if you have time to experiment with it. Now the market for low output amplifiers is very much booming, so it's interesting to follow the development. I will come up with other options later on, but this is what I started with, and it's a very interesting feel, so you might want to try it. See you later.